I am Polygroid and you are learning at Impolygroid channel. Enjoy and have a great time.
There are no soulmates. There is no one. And yet, it could be said that the core of human concern is a desire to connect. Upon further exploration of this phenomenon, it becomes clear that there is only so much one can glean from examining a single life. Tequila. Congratulations, you're married. Yeah. For now. Thanks. Because for every choice that subject makes, someone else is out there charting an entirely different course. Bullet rocks. Marcus Watkins had always adapted as a means of survival, carefully constructing chameleonic variations of himself in order to present a certain facade to the world. As a result, his own impulses were often shrouded in a fog of self-consciousness. What's up, nerd? Hey, babe. Sorry, it's Keely. Josh has been all over me to get something good. Finish that shit so we can dance. Yeah, totally. Just, give me 1 second. Okay. You gotta get them to stop putting you on those influencer books. I think she's about to leave me alone. I will come find you. Sure you don't wanna do a bump? I'm good. I did one earlier. Yeah, like an hour ago. This is the story of Marcus Watkins. You're in my hiding spot, dude. Nah, this is, my hiding spot. I've been coming out here all night. Okay. Who you hiding from? Darby, she keeps trying to get me to dance. I'm like, dance with your husband. What? Are you one of those? Doesn't dance at weddings, people. I can't dance in a room full of white people. I feel I'm on display. Yup. They turn and look. You'd be like, what? No. I know the feeling. Although, truth be told, I'm not a great dancer, so. Oh. That's too bad. Come on. This is dumb. This. Sorry, it's like BuzzFeed became sentient and wrote a book. What are you, a book critic? Close, I'm a book editor. Oh. That's usually the response I get. I'm sorry. Let me try that again. That's incredible. Wow. Okay, all right. A book editor. Oh. I know. Is this guy lost or what? So, Mr. Book Editor. Do you have any recommendations for me? Oh. Well, what are you into? Reading. All right, smart ass. My favorite thing I've read recently is this sci-fi thing set in this alternate universe where Haiti was never colonized. That's cool. Yeah. What's it called? It's not published yet. You had one job. Yeah, I know. One. I know, I'm sorry. But it's real good. I can't stop thinking about it. And it's written by this kid who's like finishing up the grad program over at Columbia. Can you send it to me? Yeah, all right, yeah. Give me your email. I'm Marcus, by the way. Mia. So, how'd you end up at this sadist wedding? My wife used to work with Magnus. Cool. Yeah, we were surprised. We even got the invite. He's not even that close with Emily. Emily. Yeah, she's the one doing the ice luge with the bride. That makes sense. What's that supposed to mean? Makes sense. Nothing. Oh. Fucking finally, here's my Uber. It was nice meeting you. Nice to meet you, too. For Mia. When Marcus met his wife, Emily, their very coupling had been a way for him to rebel. While she wasn't considered the right choice in his family of origin, she was his choice. And that was all that mattered. Cake coming in. Beep, beep. Time to celebrate the bride and groom. Mag, Put me down. Put me down. No, Magnus, Magnus, put me down. Okay. Sorry. I just don't like that. I'm sorry. Alright, who wants cake? Who wants it? Who are you? Magnus' friend. Ooh. We got a wrong answer. Give me the knife. Easy there, killer. We don't want a lawsuit. Woo. I had so much fun. Yeah, I bet you did, Scarface. Did you? Yeah. Yeah, totally. Sorry I couldn't get on your level. Okay, I'm coming down now. You didn't do any mingling. No, I just had to deal with that work shit. I feel like I saw you talking to some girl. You feel like you saw me? Yes. Who was she? Don't know. Some girl who works with Darby. Ooh. Some girl who works with Darby. With a really nice red dress. Come on. Okay. I gotta go to sleep. Good night. Good night. Unless you wanna have sex. Oh. Yeah, yeah. I'm really tired. It's okay. As soon as I said it, I was like. But tomorrow, though. Tomorrow. Gonna wear that ass out. Ooh, okay. Can you put on a podcast? Now that I can do. What do you wanna listen to? Anything. I just need some noise. This is Fresh Air. I'm Terry Gross. My guest, Comic W. Kamau Bell. Yes. Oh, hell yeah. CNN, where he's hosting a new docuseries. What's up, Marcus? Morning. Freddy. Hey, what's up, Marcus? What's going on? Alright, you got a lot going on. You got a Trey Lang. Yo, buddy. Hey, Josh, what's up? How's Keeley's book coming? It's coming. We got a title, Influencee to Influencer. In 140 easy steps, open parentheses. Really 141 steps, but who's counting? Winky face emoji, close parentheses. That's the whole title. Yeah. That's too long. You think? You know how well these books do. You're really carving out a new niche. Books for people who don't read. Yeah. I'm gonna move to straight up picture books. Sorry to interrupt, but Trey Lang is here. Should I grab him? Oh. Yeah, I'm ready. The Columbia grad student I was telling you about. Did you read his book? No, Marcus, the last Afrofuturism book that you foisted upon me sold shit. It wasn't that bad. Besides, this, one for them. One for me, model. Doesn't work if I never get one. Can you just summarize it for me? Like, half a page. Sure, okay. Cool. Damn, white people wilding around here. Yeah. Trey. Marcus Watkins. Sup, Marcus Watkins. Alright. I gotta tell you. I've been really looking forward to this meeting. How come you got no brothers on the wall? Do the right thing. Oh. Yeah, right, Sals. Funny. I'm fucking with you. You got plenty of black people up there. What are you, head of the urban division? I try to create more opportunities for writers of color, sure. But what I loved about you is that you're young and honest, and, man, your writing is so visceral. Together, we can refine it. Crazy. Now they got black dudes telling me it's too black instead of white guys. Whoa. No, I didn't say it was too black. I'm not dumb. I know what refined is code for. Alright, let me explain what I can do for you. My job is to nurture your vision and ultimately to fight for you. We have to get it in shape first. So you're a fighter? Yeah, I'd say so. I'd say you're the middleman. I'm not trying to insult you. I get it. We need guys like you to translate guys like me. I'm sorry, guys like me. Come on, Barack. Safe, non-threatening. Al Roker, LeVar Burton, Samuel L. Jackson. Samuel L. Jackson. Non-threatening. You think you get to go from Pulp Fiction to Capital One? If you really scare white people, I'd like to talk about the book. See, that's just it, man. I say crazy shit all the time. And if you wanna be my editor, you gotta be ready to spar with me. Okay. Look, you are genuinely talented. And this is a good manuscript. That could be a great book. You've obviously come here with preconceived notions about who I am, what I do and how I do it. I'm gonna be honest with you. No one is gonna buy this book, including this company, the way it is. But if you are willing to pull up your sleeves and do the work, we can get it there. Classic Obama. Look, man, I'm just trying to be real with you. Huh. Thought you liked to spar. Yeah, whatever, Marcus Watkins. I think this meeting is over. I'ma go meet the other editors I gotta meet with. Okay, that's fine. Good luck finding one that will publish a 1,000-page book from an unknown author. Fuck y'all looking at. That's a pretty hot Sam Jackson take. The kid's a fucking nut. But that's what you do. You're the nut gatherer. Dealing with nutty ass writers. I tried to dap him up. And he goes with this white guy business handshake. He went for the graduation handshake. Like I'm some square that can't dap you up. Sound like he hit you straight to the basket. Everybody vying for your approval. Now you're vying for his. You should be a psychiatrist. I should, dealing with your weak ass problems. I can't believe this kid didn't dap me up. Hold on 1 second. Hold that thought. Yo, it's Yogi. Ah, Mr. DiMarzio, how are you, man? Nothing. Chilling with Carmelo and Kristaps. Wondering why you ain't got the 2017 suite. 2017 is our year. Uzu. Full of linguine. Like you like it. Ah. My pasta brother. All right, man, talk soon. Tell your wife I said hello. All right. Big bitch. Hello. I thought you sold luxury boxes. Sounds like you got demoted to concessions. They love pasta. I don't know what it is. He don't even watch the game. All he do is eat the linguine. Him and his wife do the little. Then they kiss. Anyway, I'm trying to tell you. Don't let this dude get you off your square. You know what you are. Who you are. You're a happy dude. You're successful. He's not. Fuck, I am. Man, you're right. You're right. Man, fuck Trey, small ass child. Yeah, he's shorter than me. And I'm not tall, you know. Give me a scratch. Okay, I'm good. Thank you. It's so funny how the scratching feels amazing. And then the second it's too much, it's like, stop. And also, will you put a carrot in my ass? Sorry. Sorry, work stuff. Can I ask you something? What? Who am I like? Who are you like? Yeah, like, who do you I remind you of? Who am I similar to? A celebrity, if that helps. A black celebrity. Is this a trap? No. I was trying to narrow it down for you. I mean, I know this is really obvious. Especially since we met right around inauguration. But I have to say Obama. Really? Why? He's so smart and, like, poised. He unifies people, you know. He never gets angry. He always keeps his cool. Thanks. Are you mad? No. I think being compared to the president is a huge compliment. And it is. It totally is. This was your idea. Yeah, I know. So, I haven't thought about this in years. But I know who else you remind me of. Who? I had the biggest crush on him when I was a kid. The Reading Rainbow guy. And I remember he had an earring, too. And that just blew my mind. You've never thought about getting an earning, right? Marcus knew. Mia was in a relationship. But he was, too, Cirilli. What was the harm in them continuing to talk? You're gonna want me back. In your arms. Hey, asshole, move. One day. You're gonna want me back. Hiding in the plausible deniability of their friendship. Marcus was able to converse with Mia constantly. I issued a formal apology on my YouTube channel. I talked about it honestly ad nauseum for an hour, and most of my videos are only 30 minutes, so I feel like I don't know, I'm just like, do I need to keep bringing it up and hashing it out in this book? He took her apparent reciprocity as a sign that the relationship she was in had just as many cracks as his own. Can I get a Greek salad? I'd like the chicken Caesar. But sub broccoli for chicken. Yo, what the fuck? What? Don't worry about it. Sub broccoli for chicken. On a chicken Caesar. Yes, it's the Caesar taste. But I wanted more green. She just wants a bag of roughage. I would really love your finest bag of roughage, please. Thank you. Wow. Now it's like a thing where two black people arguing about vegetables in the store. For years, Emily's regular night shifts at Maeve had afforded both her and Marcus an autonomy that each of them had always tried to reinforce with a mutual trust. Marcus had, on multiple occasions, tested the trust with so-called harmless crushes. Technically, he'd never crossed the line. Hey, I thought you had the night off. No, I'll be back late. Tiffany's out sick. And we're short-staffed. All good, have a good night. You, too. In your arms. You're gonna need me one day. You're gonna want me back. But this time around, Mia was the only thing he could think about. Tell me who's gonna take the heartbreak I took and still be there at the close of the book when you've grown older and lost your way and all your rainbows have turned to gray. You better stop and think about what you're doing. You better stop and think about what you're doing. Well, give a little back of what you've been taking. You better start being real and stop your faking. You better prepare yourself, ooh, for that rainy day. You better throw a little. Hey, sorry I'm late. Oh, just, 35 minutes, no worries. Wow. You're calling me out with specifics. You look good. I'm coming from something else. So don't read into it. How long is the boyfriend gone? He's always out of town for work. We're long distance. Oh, man, how's that going? It is going. Where's your girl? She's working tonight. She know we're hanging out. What are you trying to do me? I'm just curious. This isn't illicit. We're just hanging. Exactly. So how long you guys been married? 4 years, but we've been together since grad school. And, you know, I do feel guilty being here. You should. What about you? My situation is different. How so? 'Cause it's my business. You're. So, before, Emily. You ever dated a black woman? Oh, snap. We doing this now? We are, yeah. All right. Yeah, I mean, I've dated black women. Ever been in a long-term relationship with one? That's what I thought. All right. Wait. I know what you're thinking. But I'm not that guy. I always thought that I'd marry a black woman somewhere down the line. But then I just ended up with Emily, so that's really romantic. Oh. Come on, I don't know. Mia, I'm sure I have my issues, but I guess deep down, I was always afraid of fucking it up with them. Would you fuck things up with me? You're fucking flirting, man. Yeah. It's a habit. You know, honestly, I haven't been in that many relationships, period. There was high school and college. And then there was Emily, so. Mr. Monogamy. Well, kind of. Seriously, what is wrong with you? I'm fucking with you, sorry. We're obviously both just bored. So we might as well have fun. I'm hungry. You hungry? You probably can't sub for broccoli here. You know what? Just for that, I'm asking. Two more vodka DCs, aka Diet Cokes. Flying at you. You almost made it sound like a real drink. It is. Your parents are really attractive. Oh, I know. Probably why they got divorced and married a couple uggos. One hottie per household. This hadn't occurred to me. When I sat here, I swear to God. Yeah, who sits in the middle of someone's couch? You have all these pillows and all expensive looking. Really. But there's just so much space. You can move a pillow. I know, but I mean, yeah. I probably could have, yeah. Empower yourself. So, what do your parents do? My mom is a loan manager at the Bank of Maryland. Oh, wow. Yeah. And my dad owns 6 Popeyes. Yo, what? Yeah, everyone reacts like that, I know. My mom gave my dad the loan for his first Popeyes. Oh, wow. And then he left her. Oh, my God. I know. It's trifling, right? I was like, am I gonna go live? And I did. He fucking left her. Do you want me to move over? You can do whatever you want. I should probably head home. I have an early morning. Yeah, I have an earlier morning. This was fun. Yeah. Good stuff. Yeah, great stuff. Okay. Bye. There is a problem. What did I do? Hi. Hey, I thought you hated this show. What time is it? Is it super late? Kinda, last minute dinner. With some agents. And then we out. And got some drinks afterwards, so. Yeah, I'm sorry. I didn't text you. Was work all right? Everything okay? Yeah. Yeah, I'm just tired. Okay, good night. Good night. Yes. Here, bro. Don't chug it. It's vodka. You ever give him the wrong sippy cup? Oh. Yeah, one time. He threw it right up, too. His first drink, man. There you go, sweetheart. Armbar. Hey. It's okay. Somebody called you Van Jones. No. You're Marcus. I'll kick somebody's ass, bro. No. I meet someone else. I think. What do you mean you think? Unless it's a ghost. No, like it might be something real. Even though she has a boyfriend. Oh, my God, are you serious? That's why I don't leave the house. Shit like that. Do my errands. Do shit with the kids. I go home. That's messy. What are you doing? Can I show you a picture? No. You make me like her. Then I'm thinking about her. I don't wanna be a part of it. Here we go. Let me see, hurry up. Oh, damn. Yeah. What are you worried about? You have no chance with this girl. All right. Whoa. You let me see. Now let me live. I'm invested. Yogi's approval. Let me see. Oh, PG County. She went to Spelman. She makes more money than you. How do you know? I can tell, smooth ass forehead. That nose, those teeth. She probably bite her apple smooth. She got insurance. What are you really doing now? Like, Emily, that's your speed. She don't mind. Your low 5-figure salary. Whoa, high 5 figures. It's mid to high 5 figures. It's low. But I don't think Mia cares about that either. It doesn't really matter. Because we're technically just friends. Oh, we're just friends. You always show me your friends. on social media. And they always be fine as hell like that. Are you not happy with Emily? I don't know, man. Everything is just fucking off. Like, I don't feel that spark anymore. Let me ask you a question. When's the last time y'all did a romantic getaway? Me and Tina, we do a little Catskills weekend. The fucking mountains are not gonna fix this. I feel like I can't show her who I really am. Okay, Spider-Man. What are you talking about? No, I'm serious. We fell in love with these versions of each other. And now the dust is settled. And, bro, we're just us. You sound like one of them. White-ass books you be selling, man. You gotta work at this shit. Make the happiness happen. I'ma tell you something that you might not wanna hear. This Mia shit. Shut it down, bro. Shut it down, man. Go home to your wife, bro. Yeah, you. Yeah, you're right. You're right. You're totally right. I know I'm right. That's what's up, baby, yes. There you go. There you go. Hey, what's up? Yo, how you feeling today? Honestly, I'm pretty hungover. I think I'm gonna take it easy. Get in the bath, crawl into bed. I don't know. You. Is that soup up yet? Thank you. Alright, I'll take an Advil. And do you have anything else? That's good for a hangover. Dope. Yo, hold that. Hold that door. Can I help you? Amari Stoudemire. Bingo. Who is it? Babe, you ordered food. No. Postmates. Okay. Huh. Yo, Gatorade. My man, I appreciate that. All right. All Marcus could think was thank God he hadn't risked everything for someone so utterly out of his league. At least now he knew. And a distinct focus washed over him. Marcus had been acting crazy. He had always loved Emily. Sure, they'd been on autopilot for a while. But what couple hasn't had their rough patches? Hey, what's wrong? The first year I brought her home to Michigan for Christmas, she said the yams were too spicy. So my family still just calls her Spicy M. Hang on, I'm just scrolling through a bunch of pictures of ugly white babies. M. Sorry, I know I'm being mean. This is just my only outlet. Oh. And how about these? From literally the middle of the fucking night last night. I don't think she understands me. You understand me better than my own wife. And then I shouldn't have gotten married so young. I feel stuck. Are you with me, Jasmine? Can you let me in? Would you love me open? Like a bottle of gin. Jasmine. Is it cause I scheme? Is it cause I knew? She got the Jasmine. Moving it quickly past me. Jasmine.